with the crowd singing along, I just remember what we're doing is important and that people are connecting to this. And still, even after all this time, that's what's real, honestly. That's what it, you know, it's bigger than the songs or the notes or the guitars. Really fun record to make. I think it was a very defining record for us. I can remember driving to and from the studio every day with Matt and listening to bounces that we had in the van, and we'd just listen to it. And I remember being kind of nervous, kind of second guessing what we were doing, because it felt like a bigger departure than we had done up to that point. First time we showed Me Who I Am to Ben, I remember he had made like a little piano demo, and I remember getting goosebumps the first time I heard it. I was immediately impressed by the lyrics and by just like the ideas that he was able to convey. It was something I was very much looking forward to recording.
Oh yeah, it was great. I just went to a concert of
I'd say really loud.
Do you like it?
Mm-hmm.
No, not a question.
Mm-hmm.
What album? What? And I'm just like, like, gotta make sure they hear.
That was the first album I'd ever heard. Was an awesome album. One of their best.
The writing is so poignant and like just like hits people, and I think that's why it's been like such a relevant album still, I guess.
They were able to take so many elements of what was happening in the scene and just combine it so well. I'm grateful that they came back 10 years later and let us all just go back in time.
See that line, I never should have crossed it. Stop right there, I never should have said that. It's the very moment that I wish that I could take back.